dirty bit.
Today's collection was inspired by lace and love, and she's just the piece that represents being heartbroken and hollow and empty inside, but still wonderfully delicious as she looks.
How many pieces did you show?
20. It was a 20-piece collection.
Inspiration was?
Lace. It was about lace and love from beginning to end. It was a really dramatic story.
How long have you been designing, Bunny?
Only 2 or 3 short years. I haven't been doing this long, but I love every minute of it.
Where can we see your pieces? Do you have a website?
Sure. My pieces can be found on www.facebook.com/BELJRE.
Okay, what's your model's name?
This is Marsha. She's my muse, actually.
She's your muse?
Yes,
can we?
My inspiration.
Okay. Hi, Marsha.
Hi, how are you?
Very pretty.
Thank you.
You closed the show?
No, I opened.
She opened. Ah. All right, well, it was nice talking to you, Bunny.
Thank you for having me.
And Marsha.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. This is Rocky Hat. Stay tuned. I'm here with Rebel, the second designer to hit the runway. She's from Boston, Massachusetts. Welcome, Rebel.
Hello. How are you?
How are you doing?
I'm fine. I'm tired.
Tired? Tell me a little bit about the line you created for this fashion show.
I showed reckless sophistication. It's a mix of sportswear, formal wear, casual, and business wear.
How long did it take for you to put together a line for this fashion show?
I've been working on it for about a month. The last three looks, the last three gowns I did the last week.
Runaways for me. Oh. I won't buy it. But how many pieces did you put together in a month?
About 20.
Good. You're good. Something you're not telling me, Rebel.
No. I did all the sewing, all the creating.
What was the colors like? What was the inspiration?
I like black and white. So that's the basis of all my collections. So I use black, white, and red and yellow for this one.
With the name Rebel.
My initials are R-E-B-L. So Rebel.
Rebel, I heard a little birdie said that you may be doing a men's line.
I'm working on it. It's called Renegade by Rebel. Men are a little bit difficult to design for because I don't want to go too far to the left and then everybody's looking at me like, what is this? I'm not wearing it. So I'm working it out.
Rebel, the designer for tonight, the second designer to hit the runway. Stay tuned. This is Rocky Hess. Thank you very much.
No problem. Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm here with B. Chris Couture by Baba Christian. Welcome. How are you doing? You were the third designer to hit the runway.
Yes, I was the third designer. So that was good.
Out of 13.
Yes.
How are you feeling about that?
I feel good. I feel like the collection that I previewed today was really good, and I got to tell a story with my collection as well. My story is the history of Africa. I was born in Ghana, West Africa, so a lot of the clothes that I made today were inspired by African culture, the African patterns, the African everything, African culture.
How long have you been designing?
Designing professionally 5 years now.
No.
No, this is like, I don't know, like my 50th show. I've been, yeah, professionally for 5 years now. So
you live here in New York?
Yes, I'm based in Westchester, New York.
Okay. Thank you so much. We're here with B. Chris. It was great talking to you, and your show is awesome, and we hope to see you again in the near future.
Thank you for having me.
Bye.
Thank you. I'm here with designer Austin Paul, the 13th designer to hit the stage tonight. Welcome, Austin Paul. How are you doing?
I'm good.
Well, tell me a little bit about the collection and your inspiration.
The collection and the inspiration is just regal, young, thriving professional at the peak of his game. And he likes to wear really nice and flashy things.
So the colors, what inspired you to mix the colors? I see flowers.
I'm a down-to-earth person, so I like earth tones and pop colors, and you get the reds and the bright greens with the browns and the tans and the blacks and the grays, some grays.
It looks a bit Caribbean-like. I see the flat, the palm trees, like my swagger, the red colors. Is it anything to do with the Caribbean here?
You have some from my father's side.
Beautiful, stop.
We all American.
Oh, I don't think you're all. Your daddy is Jamaican. So how many pieces are you showing tonight in the collection?
Showing 14 pieces. There's some faux furs. There's some real furs.
Watch out for PETA.
Nah, they're not going to get me. Some heavy vinyls. And washable fabric, like cottons.
Oh, tell me a little bit about what's here, this jacket.
This is a new camouflage blazer. It's actually a suit, but he's just wearing the jacket right now. It's a new camouflage. I call it a new camouflage because it has all the camouflage colors, but it also has flowers in it that you can see if you like really pay attention, some palm tree leaves.
Very Jamaican.
Yeah.
Love it. very nice. And model is?
My name's Ola.
Ola, you look very nice in this jacket.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Tell me a little bit about what's on your left.
This is a fun Miami-looking suit. It has the same palm tree-esque leaves in it, some more flowers. They're a little bit more spaced out, but they're also like at a larger scale, which makes it a little bit, it gives it that more expensive.
So the pockets are different shapes, is that?
Yes, that's one of my signatures. I love pleats, so the pocket is a pleat with a flap over it, and a guard, a pleat with a flap over it, and a guard.
That style is from European, or the?
It's a meat.
It's an Austin Paul. I love it. Very nice. What is your model's name?
My name is Tristan.
Tristan, you look very nice. Oh, thank you very much. We're looking forward to seeing you on the runway. These pieces look fabulous, Austin. Thank you for talking to us. This is Rocky Hess. Stay tuned. So I'm here with the ninth designer that hit the fashion runway tonight. How was that for you?
It was great. Like, you know, I love fashion shows. It's like calm, crazy, then go home.
This is your first time presenting with Fashion Sizzle?
With Fashion Sizzle, yes.
Where have you presented before? Where have you shown? And
well, been showing for 16 years now, so I've shown everywhere, all over Manhattan, Brooklyn, the Bronx, around the tri-state, and around the U.S. actually as well.
Where can we see your next show? Where will you be presenting next?
I don't have any more shows coming up, but you can always find me on imanilia.com. So that's imanilia.com.
Tell me a little bit about your presentation, your pieces tonight. How many pieces did you show? How many models?
I showed 20 pieces, so 20 models. Basically, this collection was about like
gowns.
Yes, it was evening wear. I do event wear, and it's about like exotic animals and evening wear. So, you know, you just like I let the fabric speak to me, and then I designed after that. I kind of did like, you know, futuristic jumpsuit and like this iridescent snake skin and all kinds of crazy stuff like that. But I do evening wear, what I like to call event wear.
Event wear, that's cute. That's different. Where was your inspiration from? What was it behind? And how long did it take for you to prepare for the show?
I mean, it varies. This is an extended collection, so I had already had a portion of the collection done, and then I added to it. I mean, designing a collection in full, it takes time. It can take, you know, 6 months to a year, honestly. It varies. It depends on what you're doing and what you're doing before.
That sounds great. Well, we are looking forward to seeing you in the near future. You just given us your website.
Yes. imanilia.com.
Instagram? Do you have Instagram, Twitter?
I do. Instagram is at Imanilia Fashions, and Twitter is at Imanilia Designs. You can always Facebook me, Imanilia Designs. And, I mean, Google Imanilia, and you'll find all my social networks, as well as if you visit the website.
Pop up.
I am there.
All right. It was nice talking to you, Imanilia.
Great talking to you.
I love your name. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
All right. Stay tuned. This is Rocky Hess.